Hello, this is Cookie RX, and welcome to Willow Springs International Raceway for Race 6 of the NROL Axalta Pro Series. Yes, this is race number 6. This is our first start of our first Willow Springs race of this channel. That will be going alongside with the Colgate Cup Series to end off the whole entire week of some doubleheader action for Richmond and Willow Springs. But we've already done two Richmond races, and now we're going to do two Willow Spring races. And yes, this is these NFSRL version 2. I just like to use it because why not? But yeah, the summer version of it fits in for June, since we're pretty much like 3 days left until summer hits us. Hope that sounds right. But I don't know. I might have to check the schedule, but I could be right. Sometimes I could be wrong if it's not actually 3 days left, but I mean, I don't know what I was gonna say. I was gonna say it depends on where you're watching, but this is gonna be uploaded by Friday, so I don't know, that might be alright, I need to stop embarrassing myself. I really need to go over for some little highlights of what happened from the Indy 100. Yes, Lance Smith Jr. did win another in our race. And he has been on a roll so far for his in our career for the other in our series that I've done so far for this year. And luckily for Zachary Deletto, he is actually still the points leader. So, ain't that good for him. But I don't know. There's still going to be some changes though, due to where he qualifies, since we can't see the 19 car to where we're seeing, but I don't know. He possibly can get another finish, but sometimes he can't. But first, it's always your first time for every racetrack that you've never went before. As I'm struggling to speak, but you know what? I'm just gonna go over it and start the starting grid before we head to the actual Californian Grand Prix. And I didn't mention the name of this race, but I've already done it now, luckily. So yeah, here's the starting grid for tonight's Californian Grand Prix race. Row 1, we got Kelly Hancock starting on the pole for tonight's Roll Spring race. Then alongside with Kelly is Aiden Joel. Row 2, we got Will Parrish and JJ Reed. Row 3, we got Mike Manfer and Joshua Robinson. Row 4, we got the previous winner, Lance Smith Jr. and Brett Moma. Row 5, we got DJ Reed and Foster Henderson. Row 6, we got Lindsey Hancock and Sammy Oskin. Row 7, we got Stephen Wallace Jr. and Wesley Keller. Row 8, we got Grace Takayama and Daniel Bouchard. Row 9, we got Joey Miles and Dylan Abrahaman. Row 10, we got Kenny Moma and Reagan Whitlock. Row 11, we got Brendan Hancock and Samuel Morris. Row 12, we got Mitchell Collins and Phil Mosco. Row 13, we got Joey Cochera and Zachary Fitzwater Sr. Row 14? Oh, I'm sorry, I need to check for a sec. Nah, that's row 14. Yeah, hopefully that's right. Row 14, we got Christian Vargas and Roberto Crown Jr. Row 15, we got Trey Smith and Zachary Davis. Row 16, we got... Yeah, row 16. A bit confused, but I can still get over it. Anyways, row 16, we got LJ Toledo and Carter Joey. Row 17, we got Priya McShane and 77 of Winnie Collin. Row 18, we got Owen Miles and Nicholas Radcliffe. Row 19, we got our current points leader, Saki Dolello and Lucy Brookie. Then finally at row 20, starting last, is Alex Kraft in the 6. So that will be it for your starting grid of tonight's Californian Grand Prix. And now we're going to get to your command to get those engines fired. Get the race report, wants to tell the pace car, gets itself back to pit lane for the first time at Willow Springs. We'll start things off with a bang for the 6th race of the NROL Axalta Pro Series.
Drivers, start your engines!
Engines have been fired up with our Axalta Pro Series drivers for their first Willow Springs race. And the pace car will wall off to these road course turns. And now we will get to your race report. 26 laps for this race. 65.0 miles. Yeah. No pit windows, obviously. Previous winner is Lance Smith Jr. This is our first 2005 mod race at Willow Springs. As the pace car will get itself back to pit lane. Until now, as we are ready to get this Californian Grand Prix race started, and the green flag has been waving for race 6 of the Axalta Pro Series. We'll go ahead and start this commentary now. As we got Lance Kelly Hancock starting off to be our leader. Only by a few minutes. Oh! We got some drivers going really loose out of that turn. Oh! Wow! Well, I knew that happened, but unfortunately, he tried to get himself back on track, but then he got into Joshua Robinson, Brett Momaa, and Lance Smith Jr., who was struggling to get himself back to the racetrack. Also, and Will Parrish might have screwed it up, but oh! Moscow was spawning out to the pit road! Dang, he might have, pressure to the one he picked, guys. No, I'm kidding. They're not actually real. But anyways, yes, Aeson Joel in the 20, right? Yeah, Aeson has passed Kelly Hancock for the lead. Also, I did forgot to mention this. I was gonna mention something about this before I get interrupted, but yes. We obviously have no cautions for this race since this one is obviously a road course, and it's pretty much going to be a wreck fest. But you'll guys be fine with that, right? All you have to do is just survive and not do some screw-ups to get or get hit by anyone. Or just let your car to force itself to hit someone, but yeah, anyways. Is Central, like I said, he will be taking over the lead now. Lindsay drops down to second. And soon she will get passed by JJ Reed by a few seconds, since he is already looking forward to go right into that first turn. But Kaylee is also going to try to save her position by doing the same thing of what JJ Reed was doing, so she will most likely be okay at second. And there's going to be a couple of drivers that are still wrecking at this track, but we won't be paying attention to all these drivers, because I can't really watch all these drivers. Like, I don't know. It's just a problem that I can't deal with sometimes. Oh, Zachary Davis with a huge damage. Jesus! Oh my god! Is this really a wreckfest? Oh, he is flipping more than once. Twice or three times, but man, he just faced a few wrecks on this 18 machine, but god, that is, you know, I don't really know what to do with this track. This track has been insane. To be honest, I really haven't watched any NFL races from this track, but I'm pretty sure it was like this before. If not, then yeah, it's pretty much my bad to start this race like this. But what can I do to let these drivers at least survive at this track? Well, yeah, unfortunately, Kelly Hancock did get involved from that wreck due to Zachary Davis's car. But, man, I'm running out of words to say. But, yeah, so like I said, it's pretty much gonna be a wreck fest without cautions out of this track. I don't know if it needs to have a few cautions, but if it doesn't, or if it does need cautions or not, then at least let me know. Did I just see someone? Oh no, that's the other drivers that are, you know, really couldn't describe how many turns because this workhorse has, but anyways, Will Parrish will now be at second, trying to get a good finish at Willow Springs. Danny Bouchard now at third. There goes DJ Reed to fourth. Lancey Hancock catching up to DJ Reed's car, trying to not do a few screw-ups here and there. And so will Grace Takeoma, which Grace is currently at 6th. And now Grace is planning to pass Lindsey Hancock. And yeah, now the 42 is currently running for the top 5. Jeez, we only got 5 drivers that are out of this track. We got Kenny Momma, Lindsey Brookie, Kelly Hancock, JJ Reed, wow. Oh yeah, he did get involved with Kelly Hancock and Zachary Davis. Right. And Zachary Davis, which I mentioned him before. But yeah, we only got 5 drivers that are out of this race by the start. But hey, it's not as bad if it's up to 10 or 15 drivers that have wrecked in this track. 7 laps out of 26 laps. 7 out of 26 laps. If I should say that correctly. Yeah, Aeson is pretty far away than the rest of the drivers. I don't know when Will Parrish will catch up to Aeson Joel, but if it's just Aeson Joel going by himself for the win at Willow Springs, then I don't know if I should really keep Willow Springs for the next Colgate Cup Series if it's gonna be like this. If it's still gonna be like that for tomorrow's race. Well, I know. Keller might have an open shot to pass Dylan Aquahuman, but for these last road course turns, to reach to the 8th lap like this, he is clearly not ready yet. Road to Crown Jr. might have almost committed some contact with Lindsey Hancock, but surely that pass wouldn't work out for him. And that also gave Wesley Keller a chance to at least try to follow Lindsey Hancock. But that doesn't work either, I don't think, so... I mean, so far, he is still going side by side with Dylan Aquahuman. He's really trying to get to 8th. But, I don't know, we may see him passing 2 drivers soon. It only just happened by a couple of minutes. Okay, there's a Joey Crutchfire with some damage from the back. And he is now 1 lap down, along with Samuel Morris and the 99 of Braden Hancock. Wesley Keller now going to the inside. I mean, now going side by side, or at least tried to, with Roberto Crown Jr. He still wasn't sure if he was ready to pass either one or two drivers, but he is making some efforts, so we still need to wait it out a bit. I mean, for like a few minutes. Ten laps of 26. Roberto continues to get close behind of Lindsey Hancock's car. Ooh. He's a bit struggling to try not to tuck out Lindsey Hancock. Wesley Keller might have the chance to pass Roberto Crown Jr. But I don't know, Roberto may still save his position, so we're gonna see if Wesley Keller can actually move to 7th. Or if he's just gonna keep his position to if, since he still can't pass Roberto Crown Jr. But, yeah, he actually did pass Roberto Crown Jr., so 7th place will go to Russell Cowher. And now what he needs to do next is to pass Lindsey Hancock for 6th place. And if Roberto Crown Jr. tries to get his position back, then all that Russell Cowher needs to do is to block him. It might be tough for a road course track like this, but you always gotta look at your mirrors to try to block a driver that is gonna pass you. There he goes. Side by side with Lindsey Hancock. Going up the hill. And I think he is clear for 6th. Well, he actually can pass 2 drivers. He only had to wait until he tries to pass 2 drivers by a few minutes. And wow, Roberto Crown Jr. already at 7th. As soon as Lindsey Hancock was soon about to lose more than 2 positions, since she is with the 2 Hendrick drivers, Dylan Abrahaman and Sima Hoskin. Oh, I just realized that Grace Takeoma is now 2nd. Alright, well, I didn't see when that happened. But, yeah, Will Parrish apparently got passed by Grace Takeoma, but kind of been shocked that he didn't get passed by Daniel Bouchard, but he still would get passed by him until now, so 3rd place will belong to Daniel Bouchard now, as Will Parrish have just lost 2 positions and was now currently running for 4th. And Lindsey Hancock did get passed by Dylan Abrahaman. Now here comes the next Hendrick driver. Side by side with Lindsey Hancock now. He's also got Joey Miles behind him, who was running for the top 10 before, but now he is at 11th. And Samet is officially now at 9th. And Joey Miles, you might have the shot to pass Lindsey Hancock. Lindsey Hancock to get himself to 10th, but I don't know, Lindsey Hancock does not want to lose any more positions, so I think she'll just be at 10th. At 14 out of 26. Will Parrish is going to try to get his position back for 3rd without trying to take him out of this track. But seems like it's going to be a difficult thing to do. Oh, he almost had it. Okay, this time he clearly has it now. He is now back for the top 3. And Lindsey Hancock had just lost 2 more positions, so now she is at 12. Wow, I thought Joey Miles would get 10th back, but currently I didn't see what happened for Lindsey Hancock, but apparently Nicholas Radcliffe just passed two drivers and then he got himself to 10th. So ain't that great for Nicholas. Oh, Daniel Bouchard might have lost it. But, that gave DJ Reed a chance to move to 4th. Finally a new position for him, or than 5th. Oh wow, Daniel was really behind him now. I'm glad he didn't just crash behind his car, but still, it was a pretty close huge shot for him. Because if he was going for the pass, then it would have been a lot crazier. A little bit crazier, but yeah, it would have been the same move. Christian Vargas is now the next driver who wants to pass Lindsey Hancock next. If it's slight, little damage. Little huge, I don't know how to describe that, but it's a little damage that he has for the nose and the hood of that car, but he can still drive. But yeah, Lindsey is gonna try to at least block the next driver to only save herself to 12th place. Otherwise, she won't be getting new positions. She would have decided to pass anyone sooner. That was almost as a bumping and banging from Roberto Crown Jr., but he's now trying to attempt to pass Wesley Keller for 6th place. So far, Wesley Keller has been taking 6th pretty strong by avoiding that pass from Roberto Crown Jr., so he's doing okay in the 12th. Wow, I don't know if we're gonna have any new leaders for this. Now DJ Reed getting behind of Will Parrish and Zero. Might be one of the next drivers that could look forward to get to the top 3 since it wasn't that third before. But let's see what's gonna happen for him by a couple minutes. Which is same goes to the other drivers. My, he is now already going side by side with him. Could he still have the shot to pass him? Well, it doesn't seem like he could. But I don't know. We'll see if he actually can pass him if he has some open spots to try to pass him. Well, so far for Will Parrish, look like he is definitely trying to save his position. Maybe so does Wesley Keller, but You'll still get passed by Roster Crown Jr. by... Right, so we get through the last turn or turns, but... Yeah, now Alberto has officially passed Wesley Keller for 6th place in the 9 car. Yes, we're going by 8 laps left for this race to end. So, it'll end sooner. It won't end soon that fast. Well, I think he still might have the shot to move to third. Yep, he's definitely clear. He is not side by side with Phil Parrish anymore. He's officially running for the top 3 position in the Summer 07 Chevy. You know, I don't really... Oh. Something might have happened for a bit, but... I don't know. Definitely looked like he was hunting for the top 5 position. Little bit of a bump coming from Crown Jr. But he's still not trying to take him out of the track too. Wow, he really has no open spots for him. Really doesn't have an open shot to pass him. But he is trying. He's trying hard to pass him, but I'm pretty sure he'll definitely get a top 5 position soon. Dion Upper Human, of course, tried to pass Wesley Keller, but he is still saving his position to 7th. Was at 6th before, but. He's not gonna try to let anyone. Oh, okay. Well, none of he tried to block him, but man, that's a bit harder for him to even try to block the first Hendrick driver. But how about a second Hendrick driver named Sim Oskin? Well, we'll see what's gonna happen next, but. Anyways, I don't normally say much about gaming stuff, but if I still had any chances to upload a new gaming video, then that will happen until Sunday, since I am currently now in a summer break right now, so I can at least focus on record and upload more in our vids for you guys. So yeah, more daily upload stuff for YouTube, for two more channels mostly. But yeah, you're gonna see a new gaming video until Sunday. I really haven't uploaded a second Gartic phone video in a while, but I really want to upload it, but then there's some times that I might have record another full gaming video too. So if I did record the second full gaming video other than a Gartic phone, then I think that will be uploaded at before that Gartic phone exists. But you know what, for this summer, I'm gonna try to at least upload more gaming videos other than just NR videos itself. But yeah, you almost likely see what's gonna happen next for Sunday when I'm done with the Colgate Cup Series race. And Lindsay Hancock did get passed by Christian Vargas too. Wow. And then she got passed by Zachary Fitzwater Sr. Oh boy. This race has not been easy for her at all. She has now dropped down to 14th. Man. Yeah, there's our points leader running for... Whoops. Running for, 15th. Nice. Anyways. Isn't Joel is still pretty far away than the rest of these drivers, and we're currently at 4 laps to go to end this race, so this might be a another win for Ace and Joel, since he did win the Hall's Indy Lights Series race at Richmond. And this definitely could be a second win at Willow Springs, so that it could be just 2 wins by a whole week. And I'm pretty sure it does happen the same for Lance Smith Jr. too. And now that's gonna happen for Ace and Joel soon until we reach through the last 3 laps. Grace Takayama still trying to catch up to Ace and Joel, but I don't know if Grace still has that much speed compared to Ace's car, but otherwise, she would just get a best finish at second. There's DJ Reed, Will Parrish. I'll check on a few drivers. So far, nothing has been changed yet, but we're gonna see if one of these drivers can actually pass the next driver to get a good finish at Willow Springs. Oh man, 2 laps to go. I really kind of want this race to end soon, but there's still some patience left in me, so I gotta do this whole race. Oh, Grace Takayama might have been catch up to Ace and Joel's car a bit. Grace might have been a she. Hopefully, but yeah, I'll just call her a she for now. But please correct me if it's a boy or a girl. Otherwise, I would have looked up the name of Grace if it's a girl's name or boy's name, but I think it's a girl's name, so I think I should be fine. Hopefully I didn't offend Grace's gender, but anyways, we got 1 lap to go, presented by the NROL League, as Ace and Joel continues to hunt for his second career win for the Axalta Pro Series. Well, not mostly for the Axalta Pro Series, just for the Cookie RX channel itself. Well, yes. Oh my goodness. She is losing more positions. She is really not been having an easy day for Willow Springs. And now she up dropped down to 16th. I don't know, there may be some possibilities that could she... Yeah, she could at least save her position, but sometimes they're not... There's not gonna be any possibilities for her to save that position, but... We have reached through our final turn of this workhorse track, as Ace and Joel will win the California Grand Prix at Willow Springs. It started out as a wreckfest, but it's not really an interesting race, but I guess this is fine? I don't know, but congrats Ace and Joel for getting two NR wins by the whole week for the Indy Lights and Axalta Pro Series. What a chat. Anyways, here's the results for the California Grand Prix. First is Ace and Joel, second Grace Takioma, third DJ Reed, fourth Will Parrish, fifth Roberto Count Jr., sixth Dan Bouchard, seventh Dylan Oppenheimer, eighth Wesley Keller, ninth Sam Hoskin, 10th Nicholas Radcliffe, 11th Joey Miles, 12th Christian Vargas, 13th Zachary Fritzmore Sr., 14th Zachary Doletto, 15th Warren Miles, 16th Lindsey Hancock, 17th Alex Kraft, 18th LJ Toledo, 19th Trey Smith, 20th Priya McShane, 21st Carter Joey, 22nd Lance Smith Jr., 23rd Brett Momo, 24th Phil Moscow, 25th Stephen Wallace Jr., 26th, Mitchell Collins, 27th, Winnie Collin, 28th, Frost Anderson, 29th, Joshua Robinson, 30th, Reagan Whitlock, 31st, Mike Manford, 32nd, Joey Cartrera, 33rd, Samuel Morris, 34th, Brendan Hancock, 35th, Kenny Woma, 36th, Lucy Brookie, 37th, Kelly Hancock, 38th, JJ Reed, and finally at 39th is Zachary Davis. 10 off the whole results of this race, so yeah, that's gonna be it. Thank you guys for watching. Look forward to the Tricky Triangle 100 race that's gonna happen at Pocono Raceway. And it sometimes will happen at July or August, but I don't know, I've been thinking about finishing the whole season of the Axalta Pro Series, so I don't know. I will start a poll if I should actually finish the whole season by at least by 3 weeks or two, but I don't know. I'll let you guys decide if I should actually finish the rest of the season or not. If some of you guys are fine waiting for more races to come by next month, like usual, but I don't know, we'll see. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and sign off. Tomorrow, though, like I said for Colgate Cup Series, we're gonna have the Reese's 400 race happening until tomorrow. So I will see you guys there. And thank you guys for watching. Congrats to Ace and Joel for getting two in our career wins this week. And I will see you guys at the next Willow Spring race for the Colgate Cup Series. Peace!